Hey everyone, so over the past few weeks I've done a lot of shopping. Like I told you in my last video, I just got a new job, so I thought I'd splurge a little bit, and here it is. I'm just gonna get straight to it. So I'll start off with Sephora, and I only planned on getting one or two things, but of course you go in for one or two things and you end up buying a lot more. That's usually how it goes for me, at least. So I will start off with the things that I actually planned on getting. And the first thing I went in to get was the Clinique 7-Day Scrub. And I had a trial version of this when I bought a 3-step a year or so ago, and I really loved it, but I just didn't feel like I could spend $19 on it, so I decided to splurge and get it this time. And it's really great because it's a nice creamy gentle scrub, and it says that you can use it every day of the week, so that shows you how gentle it is. And the next thing, let's see, is the Benefit Their Real Mascara. And this claims to have a 94% dramatic length and volume, but I mean, they have like all these claims on the side, which I find really ridiculous because I just don't expect a mascara to live up to that kind of hype. And it's really pretty metallic packaging. And it's a plastic wand, which for me, I feel is kind of like either hit or miss. I usually don't like them too much, but it's really nice. Has a lot of little spikes. And then at the tip, you can see it has a bunch of like little spikes up top. That way you can kind of get into little corners. And yeah. So, on to the things I wasn't planning on getting, but I'm really excited I did. And the first one is the Korres, however you call it, Lip Butter Trio. And I've been eyeing these lip butters for years, and another thing that I just thought was a little bit out of my price range, but I splurged. And it was actually, I think, $26 or something in the $20 range. For all three of these, which is great since each individual one's like $15. But then they had them on sale for like $19, so this whole thing was like $19. So I thought it was a sign that I needed to have it, so I got it. And let's see, the next thing I got is the Soap and Glory Hand Food. I've heard really good things about it. So we'll see. It's supposed to smell really great, and I tried it on the store, and I really love the scent, and it doesn't, it's not really greasy. It dries really quickly, so that's good. The next thing I got was the Fresh Sugar Lip Polish Scrub, and it's just a little jar of brown sugar, I guess, like brown sugar and some other ingredients in there. And I've heard really good things about this lip scrub, and my lips have been really dry. And this time of year, like you can see, I'm wearing a really bold lip, and it's really great to have nice moisturized and polished lips. So we'll see. I haven't tried it yet, and I'm really looking forward to it. And the last thing I got from Sephora was one of those, you know, when you go to check out, they have a bunch of little products to tempt you. And this was one of those products, and I totally fell for it. It's the Anastasia Brow Prep little clear brow gel, and then you also have one of their tweezers. And I've been interested in trying both products for a while, so another product I'm really excited about. After Sephora, I was in the mall, and I originally, one of the things I wanted to get at Sephora was a Bobbi Brown corrector, because I've heard really amazing things about them. And I have my Maybelline Lumi in Radiant, which is really great, but it's kind of thin, and I feel like I have to kind of cake it on or put a lot on to get a nice coverage of my dark circles under my eyes. And I've heard that this is really concentrated and thick and covers really well. So my Sephora didn't carry it, so I had to go to the Bobbi Brown counter in my mall, and I finally got it. And it's really pretty nice, sleek packaging. And here it is, just in all its pink glory. And yeah, it comes with a mirror on the other end. So my next to last top in my shopping spree was at Bath & Body Works. I've been eyeing this product for a while, and I saw it online, and I didn't get it. I resisted, and once I saw it in the store, and there was only one left of it, again, another sign I had to have it. And it's really beautiful. It's sparkly, but it's got this clear coating on the outside, so the sequins aren't just out to get destroyed by the elements outside world. It's really nice and sleek and easy to clean on the outside. And it has this really beautiful bow detail right there, bow zipper. And you open it up. It has a cute little pattern inside, and it comes with a shower gel. Oh, it's in the Cashmere Glow fragrance. So you get the shower gel, little mini, a body lotion, and a fragrance mist. And I really like these small ones, because they're a lot easier for me to use up, because I never use up the big ones. And lastly, you get this cute little marshmallow cream sparkly lip gloss, which I'm not too thrilled about. I don't really use these kind of lip glosses that much, but I'm interested to try it out and see how it is. And my last stop. Ulta. So I'm gonna take everything out of this bag so it's not loud. Okay. Have it all in my lap here. So Redken was having buy two get one free of their hair products. So I've been needing some shampoo and conditioner, and I decided to get some there. And I got the all soft range because my hair's been really dry and I need something to really moisturize it. And I've heard really good things about this really helping out dry hair, so we'll see. I have the All Soft Shampoo and the conditioner right here. And interesting, the shampoo and the conditioner are not the same size. This is blowing my mind, because apparently I've heard people review these, I've heard that you're supposed to shampoo twice and then only condition once, and that's why there's a size difference. So I think I might try that and see if it does anything, you know, special. Because, I mean, I have all this extra, so we'll see. So then I have the Supple Touch Softening Cream Spray for dry and brittle hair. And this is just a spray you put in after you get out of the shower, before you style your hair. Hopefully it will give you a little added moisture. So another product I'm interested in trying. I'm really excited about this range, and hopefully it'll do wonders for my dry hair. Last thing I got, another product I've been meaning to try by Anastasia is their Brow Powder Duo. And I got mine in the medium ash, medium brown. And I really like it Ulta. They didn't have this at Sephora. Actually, Sephora is pretty much always out of this shade, so I've been trying to get it for a while and I hadn't been able to, but with Ulta, they have a little chart that tells you if you're a redhead, you should get this shade. If you're a light to medium brown, you should get this particular shade. And I find those are really helpful, especially if you don't have a sales associate handy right away, to kind of make a decision on what, which one's right for you. And so you have the light powder and the dark powder. I think the light powder you're supposed to put over the majority of your brows, and then the dark powder is supposed to go towards the ends. And yeah, it has a mirror in it as well. It's really nice packaging. It's really fancy. So yeah, that's my haul. That's all my products. Hopefully, if you were able to make it to the end, that yeah, you enjoyed it. So yeah, thanks for watching. Bye.